Hey everyone, Flipper Zero recently released version 1.0 of their firmware. Talking Sasquatch covered many of the features in his recent video, so be sure to check it out. One of the features mentioned was Listen to Walkie-Talkies. This isn't a new feature, but the 1.0 release increased awareness of it. Last month, we used this feature to play music between two Flipper Zeros. Rocket God and Talking Sasquatch recently had videos on how to listen to radios tuned to 433 MHz. In this video, we'll focus on the 22-channel walkie-talkies. The Flipper Zero radio can receive channels 1 through 7 and 15 through 22. The Flipper Zero doesn't have a microphone, so you can't talk back. We'll update Frequency Analyzer to support our walkie-talkies. We'll add our new frequencies to the sub-gigahertz read, and we'll add an external pin for sound. Many of my subscribers are curious to learn how the Flipper Zero works, so we'll look at some signals as well. Let's get started. I'll put a link to the walkie-talkie firmware in the video comments and video description. Go ahead and click to copy the commands to update your firmware. Open a command prompt, and then right-click and choose Paste Anyway. This will create a Flipper directory, and then it'll clone the firmware into that directory. It'll check out the walkie-talkie branch, and then it will build that code and deploy it to your Flipper Zero. Make sure your Flipper Zero is plugged into your computer and that QFlipper is not running. After a few minutes, you should get firmware update success. If you don't want to run my fork of official firmware, all of the features are documented. You can click on a feature you'd like and see what the change is that I made. You could then apply a similar change to your firmware. In the future, custom firmware may have some of this support built in. We'll start by looking at the frequency analyzer. Go to sub-gigahertz, go down to Frequency Analyzer, and then press Talk on your walkie-talkie. If you don't have my firmware, you won't see that frequency. Next, we'll go back and we'll go to Read Raw. Click on Config. And for the frequency, after all these, you'll start to see channel 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then you can back up. I'm on channel 5. For modulation, you can choose FM238 or TLK1. For sound, you can choose on so you can hear it through the Flipper's speaker, or external A6 if you want to connect an external speaker or headphone. Just a reminder, for that frequency 462 MHz, the Talk1 modulation, and the EXT A6 settings, you'll need my custom firmware edits. Next, if you're not going to be recording, I recommend that you set your threshold to about 75. This won't impact what you hear, but it will impact how much data gets saved on the Flipper Zero. If you do want to record this subfile, go ahead and keep it all dashes. Okay, with that, we're ready to hit back and then click OK to start recording. Testing, 1, 2. If you don't hear anything on your Flipper Zero, go ahead and click to the right to modify that frequency slightly. Testing, 1, 2. And then you should hear something. The Flipper can't legally broadcast on 462, but we can modify our sub-gigahertz file and pick a frequency that we can broadcast on. For broadcasting, we'll go ahead and hit Save, and then click on Save. You can find your files in SD card sub-gigahertz, and then you'll be able to right-click and say Download. Go ahead and hit Save. Open the save file, and then go over and copy this code. Select to there. and then paste. Change the frequency if you need to a frequency that's allowed in your region. Once that's done, bring up File Explorer, drag your file back into QFlipper. For external speakers, connect pin A6 and ground into your speaker inputs. Be sure that the speaker is high impedance. Don't connect, for example, a 4-ohm speaker directly to your Flipper Zero. Custom preset data for TLK1 has register data pairs. For example, we can see 1204, and then you can see 2 pound signs in front of register 12. Along with the suggestion that you could try 14. Feel free to experiment with different values, and if you want more details, you can check out the data sheet here. I recommend only changing one register value at a time, and again, the file you're updating is in the SD card sub gigahertz assets folder called setting_user. So now you know how to make your Flipper Zero work with the walkie-talkie and how to retransmit on 433 megahertz. Now I'm going to try to explain how it actually works. I'm still learning myself, so leave a comment if you have any additional information. In a previous video, I explained OOK and 2FSK, but let's review briefly. Here's an OOK transmission. We can see there's spots where there's no signal, and then there's other spots where there is signal at the carrier frequency. Sometimes the signal's also on adjacent frequencies. I think it's because I'm too close to the receiver. But basically, on one frequency, there's either tone or there's not tone. Next, we have 2FSK. Our carrier frequency is in the middle of the two tones, and we have either a tone to the left of our carrier or a tone to the right of our carrier. So OOK and 2FSK are the two types of digital signals our flipper can receive. Let's try talking on the walkie-talkie. I press the button. Testing. 1, 2. So when there's a loud sound, we have signal to the left and right of the carrier frequency. And when it's quiet, we have just the carrier frequency. So this frequency modulation is different than 2FSK. When we send GFSK signals, we slide back and forth between the two frequencies, which means we keep transmitting that carrier frequency every time we switch sides. GFSK signals may be easier for some radios to pick up. The Flipper Zero is set for 2FSK, but our walkie-talkie is using frequency modulation. When 2FSK detects a signal to the left of the frequency, we'll click the speaker on. Otherwise, we'll turn the speaker off. Okay. I'll press the talk button. Notice our speaker is now in the off position. La. Testing 1, 2. Testing 1, 2. So we saw when you talk loudly, the 2FSK picks up that frequency modulation that pops to a lower frequency and causes the speaker to turn on. Luckily for us, the Flipper Zero appears to use left and not left instead of left and right, so it doesn't matter what's happening to the right of our frequency. So whenever the audio on the left exceeds the threshold, we'll click the speaker on, and otherwise we'll turn the speaker off. And so 2FSK is able to detect the signal. All of the amplitude information is lost, and the receiving signal has to have a high amplitude to get picked up. Please let me know in the comments if I'm totally wrong, and please take a moment to like and subscribe to the channel.